Good morning. Okay, today we are going to start with our reading comprehension. Any idea what reading comprehension is? What is reading comprehension? Yes? Yes, someone tell me, what's reading comprehension? What is reading? Yes?
To read any passage which is unknown to you.
Okay, to read. Just to go through a written matter, visualizing it and reading it, that is reading. What is comprehension? It's fine if you guess.
A paragraph.
Comprehension, reading comprehension. Yes, Bitter?
Reading and then. Comprehending it and
what is comprehending? Yes, Utsav.
To understand what is written.
To understand. You read it. Reading is one part, and understanding that reading, what has taken place, is called reading comprehension. I think you need to speak loud. Okay. So reading comprehension is you read and understand what is there in the text. There are different ways of learning reading comprehension, how you go about with reading comprehension. Here, what methodology I'm going to deal with is slightly different from what you must have had in the regular class. I have no idea what you have been doing. But before that, I've got a lovely activity for you all. Just take one copy of yours and pass, right? Take your copies and pass. Right? All of you have got it? Okay. Now what I want you to do is, you see the first part, right? On the first page you have in this unit. Skip that part and come down, which is on the other side, reverse side of your page. You have introduction. Right? Okay, you saw some bubbles. Now, what's written there? Could you read? Please read the first one for me.
Childhood is a time of joy and
pleasure. Loud.
Childhood is a time of joy and pleasure.
Childhood is a time for joy and pleasure. Yes, next one.
We don't have any independence.
We don't have any independence.
We don't have any responsibilities and burdens in the world.
Okay.
Nobody understands us at or our problems.
Okay. Now, who is this based upon, these dialogues? Elders?
Children.
Children. This is for children. And these are children's view. Right. Now, discuss with your partners, just for 2 minutes, on these four areas which you strongly agree upon. Any one. I don't want all the four. Okay, and later on, I'll be coming back to you and you have to justify why you feel that's the most appropriate. Quick, 2 minutes time. It's fine, you discuss this way. No problem. No problem, you discuss, you three discuss, it's okay. 0 down to 1 point. Okay, out of the 4, 0 down to 1 point. Okay, done? Okay, one more minute. That means 3rd minute. Fine. Okay, time up. Right. Shall we put our golden hats on? Right? Fine. Could you tell me, could you zero down to something so far? Okay, what is that?
Nobody understands us or our problems.
Oh my God, nobody understands us and our problems. How many of you have taken up this?
Okay, so there are two groups who says, no one understands us and our problems. Quickly, can you tell me one issue where you feel you are not understood?
When you have to think so much, then the point is not right.
Many times we tell our moms and dads about something, but they don't believe us.
Correct. What do they say?
They say, how could I know that you were there?
Like, you are not able to justify and they are not ready to accept, yes?
They are not believing us that you are there and you are blamed.
Okay, they don't believe. They don't trust you. Fine. That's fine. And what are your problems, by the way? So soon problems in life? What are your problems? Can I share one with you? Some problems at some point?
Sometimes if something is happening while playing or doing, then when we tell the teacher, or they are not thinking, they are thinking that we are only wrong.
Again, that comes to the
yes.
question is trust only.
Yes.
Anything beyond trust?
Believe
so trust is a problem where no one trusts you.
Because if you are not doing your homework and teacher like it is incomplete and mother was, what were you doing?
Hmm.
He has someone, that's why some reason. Not directly shouted.
Who? Mother? Okay.
She directly started.
No, but what is that work you have?
Homework or anything.
But this is also homework.
But any other work you do.
Okay, jokes apart. Second point, who else? Yes. What is your choice?
Childhood is a time of joy and pleasure.
Very good. Childhood is a time for joy and pleasure. You believe that you should enjoy to the fullest, right? Come what may, I am least bothered. Huh? This is my childhood and childhood comes only once in life.
All stages come only once in life. Right? That's the secret, right?
But then you have to enjoy. Because once time goes, you ask us, we'll all tell you, yeah, childhood is the best time. No responsibilities, no tensions, no problems. TK, even if mommy doesn't believe, she has to believe at one point of time, na? Because you won't otherwise allow her to go. Right, okay, next point.
We don't have any responsibilities and burdens in the world.
Yeah, so you enjoy, right? Okay, yes?
Childhood is a time of joy and pleasure.
Childhood is a time of joy and pleasure. Anything else? But there's one more, no?
We don't have independence.
We don't have independence. No one says that. No one agrees on that. No one? Wow. That means you all have full independence?
Not full.
You agree with it? Okay.
Some places
you are not given that independence and some places you are restricted, right? So you feel. So, yes, Bitter?
Sir, I agree with this point.
You agree with this point. Why? Can you tell me in one point where your independence is curtailed? Yes?
Mom, if we are going to our friend and I am telling to my mom that I am going with cycle, my mom will tell no. Because she has
the fear.
Yes, that accident will happen.
Yes.
Or,
So she won't allow you to go by cycle. So she'll say, I'll drop you on my kinetic and then I'll come and pick you up. Which you don't like. You feel I'm not a baby. That you should come and drop me and pick me up. Yeah, you feel very bad. Right, your independence is curtailed. But then when you think from the parents' point of view and the teacher's point of view, they are also not wrong. They are very protective about you. Right, when you are with us, we want to take care of you and we are so caring. We are so loving. But sometimes the love becomes suffocating. Then you feel, hey, sure, well, let us run away from here. What is this? That happens. It happens at this age. This age, the teenage, it happens. After that, it will not happen. Then you would love when someone takes care of you. But this will happen now. Fine. Now turn to the other side. Read the first point in your mind. Have you heard this name earlier?
Yes.
What is he famous for?
Mischief.
Right? He is a mischievous. And who is the author of this novel?
Mark Twain.
Very good. Good. I'm happy. You've read this book?
Yes.
You must have only seen the hardbound and read the backside and finished.
No.
I'm sure of Bharadwaj. This is what... No.
You're correct.
Yeah, see. I'm correct. I can see the face and tell who would do what. You are one of them. Okay. Mark Twain is famous for writing such kind of stories where he will make you visualize things. Right? So, our reading comprehension is based on Tom Sawyer. I picked it up specially because I know I'm getting this group of children who will be more or less the same, right? Now, I want you all to quickly change your seating arrangements. But before that, I'll give you the printouts which I've taken into the groups of five. Could you please come out for a second? Be there. Utsav there. Leave the things. Just there. Two. You go that side. Three. You go that side. Four. And who else? Anjali.
Kashish,
come this side. Five, right? Okay, you join her. You join her. You join him. You join again that side. Quick, make it fast. That side. Second group. You come here. You go there. You join her. You join here. You join her. You're already five, no?
Yes.
Sit down in group of five. You join there. You also join there. You have three boys here? Right. Just turn in such a way that you don't make much changes, but you see that you are face to face. Okay, so take your positions in groups of five. Quickly. Don't disturb the mic. One each. And now I give you another 5 minutes to read. Listen to the instructions properly. Read the excerpts given to you. Read it thoroughly well. Refer to your dictionaries. I prefer every group has one dictionary at least. Right? I think this group doesn't have a dictionary. Okay, fine. Right. Okay. So you need a dictionary. Refer to it. And write down wherever you want to write in the passage itself. You can write down the meanings or whatever you have. And discuss in your group what that passage is talking about. Okay? Then we get back to it. All of you. They have. They've got one. You have one with you? Read quickly. 5 minutes time for all. And while you read, as I told you, underline what you feel is important. Information, difficult meanings to be written down, and then discuss what the passage is talking about. Done? Are we following typical Indian standard time, where 5 minutes never gets over? It gets extended every 1 minute. Read and discuss fast. Now, once you finish, you will discuss within your group what the passage is talking about and take down points which you feel is very, very important for the story to be complete. Done? Yes? Now discuss within your group what is the passage that you have read talks about. Okay. Enough time, I think. Right? Not over? How much time? I can't extend Indian standard time to so long. Yes. How many of you almost done? Almost done. Fine. I give you another 2 minutes time to sum up. Finish up and start discussing. And then write it down also, as I told you. The important things that you need to remember for the storyline. What happened? No problem. Try to guess the meaning. See, the smart way to save time is whenever you have a difficulty with a word, instead of wasting time on dictionary when you are running short of time, I'm talking about referring to dictionary is never a waste of time. Let me make that very clear. But when we have such tight schedules, when someone tells you that you have to finish it up within 5 minutes or 2 minutes, what you generally need to do is refer the context in which the word is used and guess out the word. Right? That's one easy way. And then you will be almost there. You will be able to understand. When you read further, or when you read previous lines and you read the next lines, you will be able to guess it out. What is the meaning of the word, that particular word split into two? You know this word. That's it. You can figure it out. Now you got it? Good. And you are breaking your head for the past 5 minutes for that. Reading comprehension, when you're attempting the examination, dictionaries will not be available. Right? Done? Good. Discussed? Fine. Fast. Now, first acid test for you all, I have divided you into three groups and I have given you one page each. Okay, somehow randomly I've named A, B, C, D also for my understanding. Now, I would like you to tell me what part of the story have you got. Okay, first of all, you need to tell me what part of the story have you got. Yes, your part. Which is your part? Ending. Sure? It's the ending part? Just 1 minute. Okay. Another 1 minute. Third part to fifth. I'm not asking you that third part to fifth part. I'm asking you the story flow. How many part can a story have? The beginning, the middle, and the end. Right. So, which part of that is with you? Yours is middle part. Sure? Sure? 100%? I'll lock it. Fine. You're also thinking about the middle. See, I told you it's an excerpt. It is not the whole story. From the novel it has been taken. And what I have given you, that I'm asking you which part it is, not from the novel.
Middle part.
Yours is middle part?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, now you're saying it is middle part. Yours, you're saying it is?
Middle.
Again middle part. Yours is also middle part. Now where is the beginning and the end then? Maybe, not sure. Be strong on what you say. That is very smart answer. Yours is the middle part. 100% sure? No doubt about it? What gives you the clue that it is the middle part? Please pay attention here. Yeah. Loud.
Tom had become indefinitely and all. It starts directly what was happened.
To him.
Without introduction.
Without introduction. Very good. Something has happened to Tom.
At last it is not like at last solution or conclusion is here. It is not.
Very good. See, he Yash says his story start, the passage given to him is starting with a situation where Tom is in such a place where there is no beginning to say why he is in such a situation. So he knows, and he's for sure, his group is for sure, that there's something which has happened to him prior to it, because of which he is in this situation. Okay. And then he comes to the conclusion that the story, the passage given to him, doesn't have a concluding part. Generally, there has to be some summing up, which is not there. So his has to be the middle part. Okay, that's what he's saying. Now, huh? You're coming to the ending part.
No, ma'am, I think it is the middle part, as here it is given the reason for why Tom is drifted away. But we were not told, means it is not given earlier that he was drifted away from the secret troubles or something, that is not given.
That's why middle.
What is the beginning? So I think it is the middle part.
Again, middle part.
Ending.
You are sure? Yes. How do you say it is the end?
Because it looks like this part of the
situation is winding up.
And then half the situation gets wound up. Half the
it is going.
How it is being wound up. Fine. The final stage. So you are sure it is?
Ending.
Ending. So you were right in the beginning when you said it was the ending. Correct? Yeah. She is right, her group is right when she said it's the end part of the story, because the summing up is there. You're also right when you said it's the middle part of the story. Unfortunately for you, and I'm sorry that you are given the page which says the unit name, it says the name of the story, and it gives you the introduction to the question also. Read the passage carefully. So it's got to be but naturally the beginning. Right? Okay. And then one more thing is there. It's there on the board. Group A,
B, C.
Group B, and Group C. Y'all were so good, y'all didn't bother to see that. I'm so happy. Because after writing, I did have a feeling I should rub it off and not give you a clue. But then y'all were such a obedient children. I'm sure Apurva sir is so lucky to have y'all in the class. So disciplined that you didn't even bother to see what's there on the board. Anyways, fine. So, now comes the crux to what we are going to further do. This group, you are the first, the beginning of the story. You are in the middle and they are at the end. Now, you've already discussed amongst yourself what is there in the passage, what is important, what are the things we need to remember in order to pull on the story further, right? Now, what I want is each group will select their leader, who will come out and present that story part. That story part. Wait, please. We'll discuss later what, who and why. I'll give you time for that. Time means only 1 minute. Not that you don't have to do a PhD on who is supposed to go and present. Because why you need to be very, very prompt and accurate in your summing up is, following this activity is another worksheet which comes to you, where you will have a couple of things to be answered. Now, you have not read the first two part, the beginning and the middle part. So you completely rely on them for your information. You don't know the beginning and you don't know the end. So you rely on them for your information, right? Same way, you don't know what is the middle and what is going to be the final stage for Tom Sawyer. So you depend on them. So the presenter needs to be so perfect in what are the details which needs to go into my presentation, right? Okay. Now, again, clue to how you should develop your presentation. The worksheet that I'm going to give you, just skim through and see what are the questions, what are the answers likely to be there. Guess out. So your presentation should be focusing on them so that you don't miss out any details. Clear? Okay. Got it? All of you? Now you don't discuss with anyone. Just see what are the questions given.
No, we don't have to take the answers.
We don't have to take the answers.
How do you know the answers? I told you, read the questions so that when you are presenting, you know what are the things that has to be there, which are important, which has been asked. You should know it, right? So you don't leave out any important information there. Done? Yes? Okay. Now quickly decide who's going to come from each group to present. Okay, Soumya, come. If they all want you to come and present, come. Few minutes. Come on, quickly, quickly. Don't waste time in discussing. Here, who's coming? You've decided who's coming? Yash is going to come? Good. Not now, wait. Here, you all have decided who's coming? Bharadwaj is coming? No?
Not yet.
Don't take such a long time to decide. No, 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 no. What she's reading is right. I think we made it very clear, A2 onwards. A2, this is A2. Turn the page. The last, yes. Okay. Yes, Soumya, shall we start?
Just a minute, ma'am.
What you need to have with you when you're coming for presentation is the points that you need to cover up while narrating the story to your friends, so they don't miss out anything important. Not explain, you don't have to explain.
You have to tell them.
You can keep the page with you and once in a while peep in if you need to. But try to do it without that so that you know your how much you remember. Time up. Yes, come. Soumya, come. The beginning of the story. Others will listen, and while listening, note down the details that you require for your completion of the story.
The story starts as the Tom Sawyer. For what reason he was drifted away from the. Drifted away his thought from the secret troubles was that that Becky Thacker had stopped going to the school. He had struggled to convince her that you come. He has struggled to convince her to come to school and whistle her down, but he failed to do that and.
What had happened to her?
She was very ill.
Okay, she was very ill, so she was not coming to the school. And that was what disturbed?
Tom.
Okay. Then?
Tom Sawyer was then no more interested in the war and nor even in the...
Piracy. Why was he not interested in the war and piracy? That was the area of his interest. But now he has lost interest in that also. Why had he lost interest in that?
His partner was...
his partner was not coming to school and he was highly disturbed. He was very upset. He was very disappointed. Okay.
Now, his aunt was very much concerned about that that Becky Thacker was not coming to the school. That aunt had tried all the remedies and she was one of the people who liked to try new things and like to give the...
Whose aunt was it? Tom Sawyer's aunt or Becky's aunt?
Becky.
Sure?
Yes.
Sure. Okay, go further.
So his aunt had tried a lot. And she liked to give medicines to the people and tried the methods for mending the health. And she had tried the remedy, whatever she could do. And she had assisted the Tom Sawyer with the oatmeal and the oatmeal diet and the blister plasters, and she had calculated the capacity and she gave the Tom Sawyer whatever she could do for making him get interested in the war,
war or getting him back to the normal life. Getting him back to the normal life. Now you said Tom Sawyer. Earlier you said Becky. So Becky's aunt was taking care of Tom Sawyer? Was it like that? Then whose aunt was it?
Tom Sawyer.
Tom Sawyer's. Cool down. It's okay. Come on. Then. Fast. Anything else?
And she had given Tom Sawyer with the hot bath.
What were the remedies she tried for him?
The hot baths.
So she tried to change so many things for him, right? She gave him oatmeal. That means her diet, his diet was changed. Then he started using water therapy, you know, giving him hot water bath, cold water bath, sit bath, this bath, that. So many baths. But did anything help Tom Sawyer? Did it help Tom Sawyer? No. He was getting the same melancholy style. There was no change in him. Right? Are we stopping here or do we have something else? Fine? Okay. Thank you. Good. Clap for her. Now next. Who's coming from this group? Right. Come.
In the middle part of the story, it goes like Tom had indifferent and persecution by the time, and his aunt means to her home, she was concentrated. She was excited for one new medicine which have came in market, and that was a painkiller, which was in the form of liquid. So she was excited to give to Tom, and then what happened? If one another boy named Sid, if he would be there, then that aunt would not means get excited to give her that painkiller. So, and she was excited to give the Tom painkiller so he can come out from the problems which he was facing in his life now and then. And that morning he felt that it would be some romantic time in his blighted condition, in his damaged condition, it could be one child with him. So he was also excited to take the medicine which that aunt was giving to her. And then again one day that aunt's yellow cat came along wearing eyeing the teaspoon. Can you just speak this one?
Voraciously.
And begging for a taste. So that cat wants to taste that medicine which that aunt have brought. So then Tom said, Peter, that cat's name was Peter. So now you are asked for it and I'll give you. Because it ain't anything mean about me. It will not affect any to me and it will, that is no advantageous for me. I cannot get out from my problems of the life and like that.
Okay. Anything else to add on to what he said? Anything missed out?
Means the painkiller was like a drug. Tom was using it and
He was getting means more deeper into his thoughts and he stopped.
What was the taste of the medicine?
Like fire.
It was like fire. It was too bitter. You know, so he was avoiding taking it. And that is why he said, yeah, fire in the liquid form. And that's what he's telling, that he tells that I don't mind giving it to you because it doesn't make any difference to me. He doesn't want, that means he doesn't want to take the medicine. He was waiting for a chance to avoid it. Okay. Thank you. Clap for him. Yes, here, who's coming?
So, as we saw in the middle part that Tom and his cat was the medicine was real bitter, so Tom poured out the medicine out from his mouth and then the cat went all over the room and she made a chaos in the room. The old granny stand up and the old lady stood up petrified with astonishment. Means the old lady got angry and she stood up and she asked to Tom, what on earth ails that cat? So Tom said, I don't know, Aunt, guess the boy. The old lady was bending down. So this scene happened in the ending part. So then Tom didn't wanted to take the medicine. And so he did this.
What did he do? He didn't want to take the medicine. So what did he do?
He just poured out the medicine out from his mouth.
He poured it out from his mouth? Or he poured it into the cat's mouth?
Cat's mouth.
He poured it into the cat's mouth. And that is why the cat was running here and there. Because it was unbearable to take the medicine. So it was unbearable. It was like as if equaling to sitting on fire. Right? And that's why he was running here and there, dropping things, falling things, breaking things, and jumping up in the air and coming down. Okay. And that's when Aunt enters. And what does she ask?
What on earth is that cat?
Ah, what is he suffering from now? What is his problem? And what's Tom Sawyer's answer?
I don't know.
He doesn't really know what has happened to him? What has happened to the cat? He knows. He's the culprit behind it, isn't it? He's the one behind it, but he has played the mischief. Sit down. Please clap for her also. Okay. Now he says, no, sir. The old lady was bending down. Tom watching with interest, emphasized by anxiety. Too late, he divided her drift. The handle of the telltale teaspoon was visible under the sofa. Where was the spoon lying?
It
was the sofa. What he must have done? He must have poured the medicine into the cat's mouth and then thrown the spoon away to hide. The handle of the telltale spoon was visible from under the sofa. Aunt Polly took it, held it up. Tom winced and dropped his eyes. Dropped his eyes. Why did he drop his eyes?
Because he
was feeling guilty that he's going to be caught now. Okay, Aunt Polly raised him by usual handle. What is his usual handle?
Yes.
Right. And cracked his head soundly with her thimble. Now, sir, what did you want to treat that poor dumb beast so for? Means for what ailment are you treating the cat? The auntie is asking him, for what? I am giving you medicine because you are so dull, you are so melancholy, you are not doing anything, you are behaving as if you are suffering from something, which no one knows. So what is this cat suffering from, that you have given the medicine to the cat? I done it out of pity for him. Huh? Because he ain't any aunt. I have you to take care of me, to give me medicines, but the cat doesn't have any aunt. So I'm taking pity on him and I'm trying to cure him by giving the medicines. Hadn't any aunt, you numbskull? What's numbskull?
Fool.
Yes. Nice way of saying fool, a sophisticated way. What has that got to do with it? What has that not having an aunt to do with giving the medicines there? Heaps. Because if he had one, she had burnt him out herself. She had roasted his bowels out of him, thought any more feeling that if he was a human, she would have also done the same thing you're doing to me. All right? Tom looked up in her face with just perceptible twinkle. peeping through his gravity. I know you was meaning for the best, auntie, and so I was with Peter. By giving me this bitter medicine, I know you were meaning to be good to me because you wanted me to be cured. And I was also doing the same thing to the cat. I was also being good. I want him to be cured. It done him good too. I never seen him get around so. I've never seen him so active before. It has also worked. The medicine has also worked on him. Now he's so active. Right? Now do you get the story clearly, all of you? Have you understood the story of Tom Sawyer? Right. Quickly work out the exercise that is given now. Sid was his cousin. Sid is cousin. So just in reference that if Sid was here, what would happen? We usually say cousin. We don't say cousin brother or cousin sister. Unless and until the listener asks you, it's your brother or a sister. Otherwise, we generally say my cousin. We don't say cousin brother, cousin sister. That's a wrong usage. We say it's my cousin. Then if you want to specify, then we generally make it clear it's brother or sister. Do it in groups first. This should not take much time because we've already done a lot of discussion. On the basis of your reading of the extract, tick the most appropriate answer. Discuss in your group and do it. Done? Three, yes? All. Even at the back you have one more. Up to A4. Up to A4. Now you will not look into the dictionary for the meanings. Now you have to guess. Because you already know the passage. I will read out the para one because you need to know the context. No exchange. I'll read it out. You'll listen to it. One of the reasons why Tom's mind had drifted away for its secret troubles was that it had found a new and weighty matter to interest itself about. Becky Thatcher had stopped coming to school. Tom had struggled with his pride a few days and tried to whistle her down the wind, but failed. He began to find himself hanging around her father's house all night and feeling very miserable. She was ill. What if she should die? There was distraction in the thought. Tom Sawyer no longer had interest in war nor even piracy. The charm of life was gone. There was nothing but dreariness left. He put his hoop away and his bat. There was no joy in them anymore. His aunt was concerned. She began to try all manners of remedies on him. She was one of those people who are infatuated with patent medicines and all newfangled methods of producing health or mending it. So infatuated. Right? Now the word melancholy.
Can you read para 6?
I will read para 2 also first. Do you have para 2? She tried every remedy she could. Yet, notwithstanding all this, the boy grew more and more melancholy and pale and dejected. Okay. What is the third word? Gravity. Para? 6. Aunt Polly entered in time to see him throw a few double somersaults, deliver a final mighty hurrah, and sail through the open window, carrying the rest of the flower pots with him. The old lady stood petrified with astonishment, peering over her glasses. Tom lay on the floor, hysterical with laughter. Right? Done? Okay. Coming to A2. You'll just raise your hand. and give the answer. Tom's mind was drifted away because, yes.
Because
Becky Thatcher
had stopped coming to school.
Because Becky Thatcher had stopped coming to school. Aunt Polly was concerned because, yes.
Tom no longer took interest in
anything. That is why she was worried. Okay. Then next one. She was filled with gratitude when she tested the new medicine as. Yash?
It was simply fire in liquid.
It was simply fire in liquid form. Very good. Next. Mending the health of a crack means. Yes.
Looking after his health.
Looking after his health, right? Okay. On the basis of your reading of the extract, tick mark the most appropriate meaning of the given word. Infatuated. Yes, dear?
Fond.
Good. Melancholy. Yes?
Disappointed.
Melancholy is disappointed?
Yes, ma'am.
Sure?
Yes.
If I say it's not disappointed, then?
Worried.
It is sad.
Sad.
Then, petrified. Yes.
Stunned.
Okay. When you're shock type, petrified. Gravity. Yes. No. Some new face, new hands. You said, na? One answer you also said. You also said. Yes.
Joyfulness.
No. Now there's only something left. Mischief is over. Joy is over. Only two are there. Yes.
Seriousness.
The gravity of the issue. The seriousness of the issue. Correct. Now, A4. In pairs, discuss the following aspects of the story and then have a class discussion. You've already had it, I'm sure. Tom was not really ill, but he pretended to be ill. Was it right?
No.
No, he was really ill?
Yes.
Was he?
Yes.
Was he ill?
Yes.
He was not pretending to be ill, but because of Becky Thatcher not going to school, he was just disappointed.
So was it ill?
No.
So was he not pretending to be ill?
No.
Then?
He was just not interested in everything.
He was not interested in anything because his life was in Becky Thatcher. Yes. Okay. Next one. Usually he made a lot of fuss to take Aunt Polly's medicine. But this time he took the medicines quietly. Why do you think he took the medicines?
Because he was depressed and disappointed.
Because
he was depressed and disappointed.
He was depressed, yes. He was depressed. So he thought, okay, let me take medicine and try out if I can come out of the...
He pretended to be ill.
Huh?
Yes, pretended to be ill, so...
He had to take the medicines. What else? Couldn't it be like... What was she infatuated towards... Aunt's infatuation was towards what?
Medicine,
trying new medicines.
Yeah.
Right. So if he would not take this medicine, she would bring some other medicine.
Yeah.
She would keep on trying. That could also be the possible reason why he thought, let me take the medicine and finish it off all. Right. Okay. His aunt was worried because he was not his usual self. Instead, he showed an unusual interest in the medicine. Aunt was worried because he was showing unusual interest in the medicine. Yes. Do you think she was really worried?
Yes.
She was worried about him and she wanted him to get well
soon.
So what was she trying? She was trying different sorts of things so that he could get well soon. So that he would become active and he would start taking interest in what he was interested earlier. What was his interest earlier?
War,
piracy, then? Doing all sort of mischiefs, pranks. Okay, fine. Aunt Polly could read Tom's thoughts.
No.
Do you believe it?
No.
Yes?
Because Aunt Polly knew that she is not telling me he is not behaving well, he is being very unusual. So we can tell that I'm politically non-stop.
I'm not saying this is right and this is wrong, because I also don't and you also don't. Only Mark Twain knows what he thought when he wrote, right? But tell me, did Aunt really think she understood Tom well? What do you think?
No.
You can justify. You don't think she understood him?
Yes.
She had understood. How do you say she understood him?
Because she was worried. Because he was.
No, I'm worried about you. Does it mean I understand you?
Yes.
How?
Because you understand that why I am in problem.
I don't know why you are in problem. I know you are in problem. Why you are in problem, if I know, I understand. Yes?
So you can give solution or you can give appropriate
answers for his problems.
Yes.
So did she understand him?
No.
No, she did not understand him. Okay.
And because she didn't understand the Tom, because when she was in that medicine, was too intense, fire in the liquid, and it was too bitter and all. So Tom did not want to take.
But even then she forced him to take. Okay. Yeah.
And Polly is trying new medicines on one person or everything. So she was very busy in
finding out medicines.
Yes. So.
She did not take much time to understand.
Yes.
Tom Sawyer. Here, any answer? Different answer? You say you and Tom aunt understood Tom Sawyer? Any call on that? Anyone who would like to say yes, aunt understood Tom Sawyer very well? No. I feel somewhere I can justify saying that aunt did understand Tom Sawyer well, because I'm not saying the other answer is wrong. I'm not saying that. Because, see, the moment he stopped his being normal and he drifted away, she understood there's something which is disturbing him highly. So that's understanding the person, isn't it? When I know your normal self is this and you're not behaving in the normal way, I know there is something which is disturbing you. Right? So, aunt did understand her nephew, and she was concerned about him. And that is why she was trying all kind of lux, you know. She was trying all sort of medicines on him. She was trying his diet, changing the diet, changing his water therapy, you know, giving him hot water bath and sit bath and steam bath and all sort of things. She wanted him to be normal as soon as possible. Right? Okay. Then, Aunt Polly loved Tom Sawyer. How many of you agree on this? How do you say that she loved him so much? She was giving him bitter medicine, liquid fire, and she's worried and she's concerned. It's her love that is making her experiment on different things for Tom Sawyer. Aunt Polly really loved Tom Sawyer. Aunt Polly really loved Tom Sawyer so much, and that is why she was taking so much of care for him. Okay, now coming to the next part, children of India. Given alongside are the pictures of two boys, Shravan Kumar and Narendra Kumar. They are not related, because Kumars are, they don't think they are brothers. Working with a partner, look at the pictures and predict how each boy lives. Write your answers in the points. Now this remaining part, you all will be carrying out at home. This is for your home assignment. You need to read the both of it. And then before reading, you will complete this. Looking at the picture, you will complete this box and then go to the reading. Assess what you have read and what you have guessed is same. How much of truth is there in your guesswork and what is the reality in the passage. Right? So this is for your home assignment. Shall we call it a day? Shall we end the class here?
Yes.
Thank you so much, children, for your wonderful cooperation and being such lovely students. I'm really happy to have you all here. Hope we keep meeting like this in classes once in a while. Right? Okay. Thank you so much.